I'm going to talk about a really sexy topic today. I'm going to talk about plumbing. Plumbing of the body, better known by its government name, the lymphatic system. Now, the lymphatic system is essentially tasked with transporting fluid around the body, and it forms part of the circulatory system. It is the less famous sibling of the flamboyant vascular system, the one that transports blood. If vascular was Batman, then lymphatics is Alfred. And like Alfred, the lymphatic system is incredibly underrated. It works hard, quietly behind the scenes, ridding our bodies of toxins and waste and making sure that you stay protected. And it is vital for immune function, it is vital for toxin removal, and it's vital for maintaining fluid balance in our bodies. Now, if you've ever felt a mysterious bump on your neck, that's most likely your lymphatic system working hard, fighting off an infection. Now, when this system is overwhelmed, it can cause some problems. It's the reason why you might swell in the summer heat, so your shoes feel a bit tight. Now, when the system is badly damaged, it can cause more serious problems. Think overflowing toilet that can't be flushed because there's a pipe missing. And this is based, in this case, a disease can occur called lymphedema when the lymphatic system is seriously damaged. Now, the million-dollar question I suppose you ask is, why is this important? And with the next 12 or so minutes, I'm going to explain to you why I care so much about the lymphatic system and lymphedema, and why by the end of this talk, you should too. I want you to imagine for a second being treated for a deadly disease like cancer. You even survive it, but as a consequence, you're left to survive with an incurable condition that leaves you disfigured and in pain for the rest of your life. And there is no cure. This was the reality that faced my late uncle in 2019, who developed this disease while being treated for stage 4 cancer. And he is not alone. Every day, 250 million people globally struggle to manage this debilitating condition. It is permanent, and it has lifelong physiological, socioeconomic, and psychological consequences. It is a common consequence and lifelong risk of certain cancer treatments. To give you an example, around 40% of breast cancer survivors will develop this disease at some point. It could be a few months, or it could be a few years. And this is a lifelong risk. Up to 30% of prostate cancer, and up to 90% of head and neck cancer. And it's not just cancer that can cause this. It could be genetic, and where you are born with it. And in this case, it's called primary lymphedema. Other risks could be injury, obesity, age, or even infection. And this is called secondary lymphedema, which is what my uncle had. Now, my uncle lived in a really small city called San Francisco. And I remember at the time when I went with him to the clinic, and the swelling had gotten so bad, his legs were about 3 times the normal size. And I remember being at the clinic, and the clinician looked at it, and she said, "Oh, that's lymphedema. There's nothing we can do about that, I can tell you that much." I was shocked because I couldn't even believe that they didn't even attempt to alleviate his pain. Shortly after, I was lucky enough to join a summer school where I spent some time in a cancer rehabilitation clinic. And I realized that what happened to my uncle wasn't unique. It was actually really, really common. Now, the purpose of the summer school was to develop a solution for an unmet medical need. And so I decided to focus on lymphedema, where I developed a medtech device that would allow patients to self-manage their condition more effectively. But then I had to come back to the UK, where I had to focus on my actual PhD. But then COVID happened, so I was stuck at home. I was bored. I couldn't do any computational work because someone had hacked into the national supercomputer. I couldn't do any experimental work because we were banned from going on campus. And so it was the anniversary of my uncle's death, and I remembered the lymphedema that he suffered from. And so I decided to tinker around and play around with the idea of the medical device, and I started to build a prototype. This led me down on a journey to discover more about lymphedema. And the more I learned, the more I realized that the scale of this problem was so much bigger. COVID ended, and then I was rushed back into real life, where I had to focus on my PhD playing with bones. And when I finished my PhD 2 years ago, I had a bit of an existential crisis. I was at crossroads. I wasn't really sure what I was gonna do with my life. Should I continue my career in orthopedic trauma, which is what my actual PhD was in? And there was a lot of industry jobs for it as well. Or do I go into something a bit more fancy, like developing medical devices for heart disease, which had a lot of money? Or do I go into something like lymphedema, a disease that, despite what I said in the beginning, was not as sexy? Nobody around me knew anything about it. But it had impacted me on such a deep level, I knew that this is what I had to do. And to be honest, my original plan was to move to the mountains, live a life of solitude surrounded by an army of red pandas. This obviously did not happen, fortunately or unfortunately. So I decided to take the leap and try and solve a genuine unmet medical need, and I'm so glad I did. Because after talking to over 150 lymphedema patients, clinicians, and academics, I realized a lot of things, but here are the three main ones I'm gonna focus on today. Firstly, there is a severe lack of clinicians and facilities for lymphedema versus the number of people who are affected by this disease. Secondly, there is a severe lack of education and awareness surrounding this topic. And thirdly, current treatment strategies make self-management of lymphedema almost impossible for the majority of patients. All of them agreed that there was a severe need for new innovative solutions to treat lymphedema, which is good news for me because it told me that what I was developing was on the right track. To give you a perspective, in England alone, England, not even the UK, England spent £178 million on hospital admissions alone for lymphedema complications. And this could have been prevented if the patients had adequate and correct treatment. But access to this treatment is incredibly difficult because there is a huge lack of these services. And it's a significant problem for most. It's a global problem. And the huge impacts of lymphedema that it has on the patients has been widely documented. For example, 80% of patients had to take time off work. 50% suffered from uncontrolled pain. 36% had no treatment at all. And 1 in 4 people had to travel more than 25 kilometers to visit a clinic. And needless to say, this is a significant health problem. Yet there are very few people specialize in its management. To give you some perspective, in the whole of the UK, where 450,000 people are affected by lymphedema, there are only 5 physicians specialized in lymphedema. 5. And this huge lack of awareness from both the public and clinicians means that the condition is so under-recognized, and patients are often mismanaged and overlooked by GPs, causing the disease to worsen, and in the long term cause more devastating complications. And during this time, the disease will only get worse and worse, to the point where the patient can be immobilized and cannot function. So the patients can become lost in the system, where they can end up on a journey of 10 to 15 years before they even get a diagnosis. One patient took 36 years to get a diagnosis after being injured at 4 years old. But a lot of studies have shown that patients who under the proper care can actually do very well. Once they get diagnosed, once they get treated, once they get the right support, it's actually not visible. But we need more innovations to support this. And studies have shown that for every £1 the NHS spends on lymphedema prevention, it actually saves the NHS £100. In most education systems, the lymphatic system is almost entirely overlooked. To give you an example, before I did my PhD in engineering, I was a scientist. I studied biomedicine as an undergraduate. And if there is one thing I learned from that degree, is that our body is full of systems. We learn in great and painful detail about the cardiovascular system, the musculoskeletal system, the nervous system, down to the very painful details of cell signaling pathway systems. We had to commit this to memory. Don't ask me what it is, I don't remember. It was a trauma. And throughout this entire 3-year course, the lymphatic system was nothing but a footnote found in my course notes. And yes, this is my actual course notes from an undisclosed amount of years ago. It was like Finding Nemo or something. And this wasn't unique to my degree either. A survey conducted in the USA found that for a 4 to 5 year medical degree, less than 25 minutes was spent covering the lymphatic system, and 95% of the time, this was usually covered under a different system, such as the cardiovascular, which in comparison gets 20 hours of lecture time. 20 minutes. I spent more time hitting the snooze button this morning on my alarm clock. And St. George's University is the first and only university in the whole of UK to have the lymphatic system as a dedicated module as part of its medical degree, which is great, but this needs to happen on a wider scale. And unfortunately, though, this affects the people who suffer from lymphedema the most. Now, I've spoken to a lot of patients, and the overwhelming theme when talking to them and discussing their pain points is how difficult it is to manage, how it affects their self-confidence, how it made them feel like they lost their independence, and how hopeless and helpless they feel, and how when wearing the compression garment, something that is critical to their daily management, it felt like wearing a horrible daily armor. Why is this disease so overlooked and ignored despite this being such a big problem? How did we get here? And I'm gonna say something that's perhaps a bit controversial, and it's because we care more about curing the disease and preventing death than we do about your pain and quality of life. It's reflected in our policies, and it's reflected in we put the money, and it is detrimental. My colleague at the NHS actually joked that it was called the Don't Die service. This isn't official, by the way, but whatever you need to do to get you through the day. Conditions like lymphedema are often overlooked and ignored because it is a long-term problem. It's not going to kill you immediately, but the consequences of that is still nonetheless devastating. And diseases like cardiovascular disease, cancer, diabetes get all the love and attention and money. And this is for good reason too. It's not because they're overrated. These are the diseases that will kill us first. But we need to start having more awareness and solutions for the diseases that will cause us lifelong problems. Because in the long term, ignoring them will only cost us more money, more pain, and less productive years. As a society, we are living longer. But we are living longer with more disabilities. We are an aging society, which means that we also have to start aging healthier, which means that the disease, the pain, whether it's the chronic pain, the emotional pain, the social pain, the physical pain caused by chronic diseases like lymphedema can no longer and should no longer be ignored. So what can we do about this? Well, it starts with you, it starts with us, with policies, with the public. We need more solutions and innovations to support chronic diseases like this. We need more research in the area. We need more awareness that things like this could happen. And it's time the lymphatic system gets the attention it deserves. Now, I've spoken a lot of doom and gloom during this talk, so hopefully I haven't depressed you guys too much. But I do want to say that there is light at the end of the tunnel. There is hope. It is starting to pick up speed. There is some awareness going on. There's still a great need for research, but it is getting more attention. In 2022, the USA government launched the ARPA initiative, where it had a budget of $1.5 billion geared towards specifically for programs that address specific, urgent, and challenging problems in health. Research in lymphatic system is one of them. And this is exciting because this is Congress at the highest level of government in the USA saying that this is an urgent problem that needs addressing, not in the future, but now. And this unsung hero can no longer be ignored. And for the first time ever, the lymphatic system is getting a huge injection of funding. To give a comparison, in the UK, the Lymphedema Research Fund was given just a little under £1.5 million over 3 years by the British Heart Foundation. And this is a charity giving funding, not even the government. And so, for too long, the lymphatic system has been the Cinderella of the story, the sister that gets left behind while all the diseases get the funding and goes to the party. But historically, it hasn't always been this way. The ancient Greeks knew about the lymphatic system for thousands of years, so did the Chinese. And lymphatic massage has been practiced since ancient China in traditional Chinese medicine. You might know them by the little stone tools that has since become viral on TikTok. And somewhere in history, this vital system has been lost, and it's time we shine a spotlight on it again. If there is one thing I would like you to take away from this talk today, then it is to look after your lymph. And the next time you notice a mysterious bump on your neck, just know that's your lymphatic system working overtime, and you should start taking care of it. Thank you.